everyone, welcome back to my channel. So in the last video we discussed of how my first pregnancy went south and things went so wrong, and it was an ectopic pregnancy. In the last video we had discussed of how I got to know that it was an ectopic and stuff, and in this video we'll be discussing about the beta hell and how crazy it was for me. You know, when I was going through it, like when I had just started it, I went to YouTube and everywhere, all the doctors also in fact, and everywhere everyone mentioned that if your beta numbers are doubling, it means that it is a healthy pregnancy. But with me that was not the case, so I'll discuss my beta numbers with you all. Okay, so on 28/10 I tested, like on the home pregnancy test, I tested positive on 27th, and then I got my beta HCG done on 28th, and the value was 23.40 MIU per ml. Okay, so it was 23.40, so it was almost like a gray area, because of course it's more than 5, so it means that you're pregnant, but then if it is lower than 25, then it is always a bit of a gray area. So after 2 days, again they say that your beta numbers double every 48 to 72 hours. So I got my second beta done on 30th of October, and the beta number was 77.90. So the number had doubled. It was on the lower side, but the number had doubled. So that was, you know, a happy thing for me. Then on 1st of November, again I got the test done, and the number was 197.50, so it had doubled and it was a bit more than double. So I was very happy, and after my third beta I actually told my family members and everyone that, you know, I'm pregnant, because everybody is anyway so eager. It's already been 5 to 6 years that I've been married, and you know, everybody's just expecting the good news from us. So yeah, I was so happy and so overwhelmed, and everybody, I told my mother-in-law, I told my mom, everyone. So then the doctor said to check the beta after 3 to 4 days. So the next test I did was on 6/11 and 6th of November, and the number was 514.40. So the number was supposed to be somewhere around 600 or 700, but it was 514.40. So this was a bit concerning, like a beta before I told the family, and from next beta the numbers were concerning. So I was like, okay, it will double, you know, I was eating healthy, I was taking all the medication that the doctor had given. So yeah, I had not thought that this was an ectopic, because it was doubling and everyone said that if your beta is double, then it's a healthy pregnancy. Now on 7/11, again we did the beta, because the previous numbers were concerning. So the next beta came out to be 215.50, so it had gone down. Now this was very concerning for my doctor, my OBGYN and me. So the doctor had asked me to go get a physical visit, but then due to COVID cases and everything, we couldn't. And the doctor, we were only, you know, checking based on beta and ultrasound. So on 9/11 again we went, and the beta had gone up to 420.80. so when my beta was 215.50, my doctor was also like that maybe this is an ectopic, but the beta HCG, actually when it's less than 2000 you can hardly see anything anywhere. So, and when it's an ectopic, if you're doubtful, then you don't want the betas to rise. Betas are rising means that the pregnancy is growing, but then you don't want to grow it to grow if it is an ectopic. So that was the major concern. On 9/11 the numbers were 420.80. on 12/11 it was 720.60. the numbers were again rising. So we're so confused that, you know, it was very erratic. It was going down, it was coming up, so it was very erratic and very confusing for us. Now on 12th, actually on 14th of November, there was Diwali in 2020. So all the hospitals and doctors were unavailable. Hospitals were, I mean they were not taking in patients. So on 14th it was Diwali, and on 15th my doctor asked me to get admitted to the hospital, and they were going to medically treat me with methotrexate, and they were also prepared for a surgery in case the injection doesn't work, or it doesn't, you know, if any rupture happens of the tubes, then they were about to perform surgery on me. So it was a bit scary, but I was just praying, you know, keeping aside the emotional trauma and everything, I was just praying that, you know, I don't want to go through any surgery. So they treated me, they gave me injection on 15th of November, and from 16th again they started taking the beta HCG to see if the numbers are falling or not. So on 16th my number was 683.20, on 17th it was 565.40, on 18th it was 474.96, on 19th 373.50. So I think on 20th I was being discharged from the hospital. I was in the hospital for 4 days and I was under doctor supervision. And then the numbers were continuously falling, so the doctors were sure that the injection has had worked. So on 19th my number was 373.50, and on 21st it was 330.50, on 23-11, so the doctor had told me that it is a possibility that the numbers might bounce back after a week or so. So whenever we are treated with methotrexate, first of all, methotrexate is the injection that is used to get rid of any unwanted cells in the body that are growing. Now what happens is, even a pregnancy is an unwanted cell that has just come inside the body and it's growing, right? But when it's an ectopic, they don't want it to grow, so they treat you with methotrexate. A proper dosage is given as per your body weight, and this injection is also used for chemotherapy in cancer patients for killing off any of the unwanted cells. So that is the reason that after medically treating you with methotrexate, doctors ask you not to try for pregnancy for at least 3 months, because they want this medicine to be out of your system completely, which takes 2 to 3 months, and only after that you should try, because if the medicine is inside the system and then if you conceive, then it might be very harmful for the child also. So that is the reason that doctors ask you not to try for at least 2 to 3 months after you have been treated with methotrexate. Now on 23-11 my beta was 420 miu per ml, so it had risen to 100 units more, but then we were not very shocked, because the doctor had already told us that it might rise in between. But after that it went down. So on 23-11 it was 420, then on 30-11 it was 133.80, on 10-12 it was 36.20, and on 30-12 it went below 2. So yes, this was the complete beta hell that I went through. So you know, whenever, if you are pregnant and if your beta HCG numbers are on the lower side, it can be a healthy pregnancy also, because I have seen cases where the numbers are really low, but then later on they pick up and it is a healthy pregnancy. So don't lose hope, but most of the times it is an ectopic and it might double for 2 to 3 betas, but after that it will just start going down. So yes, that was my case with this ectopic thing, and then I was finally done, and after that for 3 months we couldn't try. So it's already May, we are in May now, because recently we also contracted COVID. Been recovering through it. So let's see where the TTC journey takes me next. The doctor had asked me not to try for 3 months, right? So in March cycle, then we were supposed to try from March, but then in March my HSG was about to happen, so I went for my HSG test. It was a bit painful, not very, but a bit, and I had already taken a painkiller, Meftal Spas, and after that also I had felt the pain. It was a very shooting pain, because I had my ectopic into my left tube, but thankfully both of my tubes are open and nice. But my periods were really late that month, so after that next cycle I missed, and then now after that I contracted COVID. So it has been a series of unfortunate events, but now I'm just hoping and praying that everything goes well, everything goes healthy, and we're excited, we're ready to try again. I'll be filming my TTC journey moving forward. Let's see. And yeah, that was all about. So the things that I wanted to mention in a zest about this ectopic thing was that if your betas are doubling, it doesn't mean that it is not an ectopic pregnancy. So just keep a check on your beta levels. Please follow whatever your OBGY is telling you to the T. just follow her religiously if she's a good doctor. I'm blessed with a very good team of doctors, amazing ultrasonologist. I have very good team of doctors, so I'm blessed in that sense. And my doctor was very proactive with me. So yeah, we managed to avoid the surgery. That was a very big plus point for us. And yes, that is all about my ectopic. In case, God forbid, I hope nobody goes through this crap, but in case you're going through it and if you have any questions, you can post in comments and I'll be more than happy to help you in any way that I can, because, you know, this is an experience that I don't think anybody wants to experience or have. But then if you have experienced it and if that bad experience can help someone in a good way, then, you know, I think that is something positive that can come out of this worst experience ever. So yeah, that is all about today. I'll be seeing you all in my next video, and hoping and praying for, you know, good things to happen in future. And India is in such a bad state at this time due to COVID cases and everything. So I'm praying, in fact, the whole world. So I'm praying for everyone, and by God's grace, we all have recovered almost. And please stay indoors. Do not go outside without any, or something very important, don't go out. And please wear double mask, do double masking, wear N95 mask, because I think in the second and the third strain in India, N95 has been recommended by the doctors. And take all the home remedies, do all the home remedies, and try to stay safe. Thank you so much. See you in my next one. Till then, bye.